Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about can main method be overloaded in Java. So by now you must be aware what method overloading exactly is. If you are not aware, please visit the video tutorial on method overloading. The link is in the description section. For now, I will just inform you that method overloading means you are using the same name with different parameters and that behaves differently. That is, the logic that is written within that main method is different from the one which is actually present. So here we have our main method, and this is the type signature which JVM looks for while executing the program. Now the question is, can we overload this main method? Now overloading the main method means, can we create another method with same name, suppose public static void, and then we are giving the same name, but now the thing is its parameter must be different. Here we have one string array and here we have not taken any parameter, and that is why it is no parameterized method and this one is parameterized method. So this can be considered as method overloading. Now what we can do is we can simply print over here overloaded main without parameter. Okay, this is overloaded main without parameter, and let's now overload one more method. Let's say public void, static void main. And why this error? You must be aware by now that you cannot have two methods with the same name. Here main and main, they are having the same name, and at the same time they are having no parameter, so this cannot be identical. You have to make some changes, and once you make the change, it will be overloading. For example, let's take one integer number. Now here also we have one parameter, and here also we have only one parameter, but there is a difference. The difference is that it accepts string array and this accepts integer value, so they both are different. Now overloaded main int type, this will print, and we will print the value that is received as number. So this is another overloaded method. You can go on creating the method main overloading by copying and pasting and increasing the number of parameters or changing this type, this int to float, to double or byte or any other type, or changing the number of parameters. For example, you can also have two parameters or three parameters, and that will also be considered as overloading. Now another one is number 2. So it is accepting two parameter of type int and float, and here you have to change it to number 1 because here you have number 1, and you can print the another one as well, like overloaded main float type. So this will be number 2. So this is how overloading is done for main at this program. Now the thing is, when you will execute this, will this call the other methods, overloaded methods, or not? Means, will these statements be printed if I run this program? Will these be printed? What do you think? So the answer is, they will not be called. Let's write over here, overloaded method will not be called or executed. And the reason behind that is because when you will run this program, JVM will search for this type signature main and it will start its execution from this point. When it will enter this body, it will print this statement that we are seeing over here, that overloaded method will not be called, and then the execution will end. And we do not have any link over here that calls any of these overloaded methods. That is why they remain idle over here without being called, and thus they will never be executed in this program. Let's run this. See, here we are getting the output that overloaded methods will not be called, and we do not see any of these statements getting printed on the screen. And the reason I have already informed you, because they are never called from the main method from where the JVM will start the execution. Now to print those things, what you can do is, you can simply call the overloaded methods as well. Now if I write this, that means I am calling main method without parameter. So this will call the main method that does not contain any parameter. If you press control and hover your mouse over this method and click, you will that this is getting called, right? Similarly, we can call other overloaded methods as well. What does it accept? It accepts one parameter of type integer. So if we pass one over here, this will call one param main call. So one param main call is getting performed at this place. Now if we want to call this one, what we can do is we need to pass two numbers. One will be of integer, that is the first parameter will be of type integer, and the other parameter will be of type float. So let's call that also. Let's pass first one as integer and let it be 10, and another one should be of type float. So let's pass over here 5f. You need to mention this f for float type, otherwise it will not accept this as float. Okay, so this is where it is calling two param overloaded main, right? If you click on this, means press control and hover your mouse and click, and you will see it is getting redirected to this method. That means this method is getting called at this place. So this is how the call is happening for the overloaded methods. Now from the main method, where JVM will start the execution, and this time all the three methods will get called, because when it enters this method on execution, first it will print this line, and then the execution will move to this line and it will call this main method. It will enter over here, and now this will get executed, means whatever is written in this main method's body will get executed. Since we have only one statement over here, so only one statement will get printed. That means overloaded main without param, right? If you had 100 statements or any logic written over here, that would have first got executed and it would have printed on the screen, and then it would again return at this place, and then after the completion of this method's execution or this line's execution, the execution will move ahead to this main one. And once we move at this place, this will get called and this statement will get printed. Now what is happening is you are passing the integer value 1, that would be stored in the number, and you are printing that number at this place. So this time overloaded main int type and your number will get printed. Okay, so here one will get printed along with this statement, and after that this execution will also get completed, and then we will call the main method with two parameters of type int and float, and you are passing 10 and 5f, that is 10 will get stored at this number 1 and 5f will get stored at this number 2, and then we will print those numbers one by one, and then again the execution will return back to this place, and now we have completed the execution of this main method, and then the program will happily end and all the tasks have been completed which is written within the main method. Thus we complete our program. Now if we run this, we will see the outputs as per our explanation. See, first this is getting printed over here, and then we are calling this main method without parameter, and it has only one statement, that is getting printed, and it returns again to this line number 9, and line number 9 will call this one, and we are printing overloaded main int type 1. See, this is getting printed over here, and then we again return back to 9, and then we will come to line number 10, and we will call this method with two parameters, and then print these two lines one by one, overloaded main int type, and the value is 10 for int, and the value for float is 5.0, because it is of type float, so 5.0 is coming with this 5 as well. So overloaded main float type is getting printed, and thus all the tasks has been completed and the program will end. So the answer to your question is that main method can be overloaded in Java. Yes, definitely you can overload main method in Java, as we have shown over here that we can overload main method any number of times, but only the catch is you need to call those methods from within the main method, that is the type signature that will be searched by JVM at the beginning of the program. If you do not call any of those overloaded methods from within the actual main method, that is they will never be called, and whatever logic is written within them will never get executed. So that is the catch. So you will have to follow up questions that can we overload main methods in Java, and will the overloaded methods get executed itself or not. So you have to explain this, that the overloaded methods will never get executed by itself. You have to call from within the main method, and you can show the example as explained over here, and you will be good to go ahead. So hope you have understood what I wanted to explain. Keep learning, keep enjoying. Please like and subscribe our channel to help us motivate. Thank you.